said, can you tell us the importance of these conversations?
Look, the importance of this conference is to educate men about the importance of creating wealth for their families. You know, if you create wealth by investing money, you are making sure that your family will always have something to fall back on if you are no longer there to provide for them. If you look at our program on the money,
yes,
you will see all the big five animals there. From each animal, there is a message. There is something that you can learn. For an example, the lion says, before spending your money, invest great wealth for you and your family. If you look at the 200 rand, it's a leopard. It says, great, clear, achievable financial goals for you and your family. And once you have them, execute the plan. Develop a plan, execute that plan so that you guys can achieve that goal.
So for the fact that you just started today, do you want to take these conversations or these platforms national so that most men or families could just benefit from it?
Yes, we do. Especially now, we know if you look at the history of South Africa at the moment, we got a high rate of gender-based violence.
Yeah.
Where kids, where women are being killed and raped every day. So we think this platform will be able to help to educate our men out there to look after their families, to protect their family. I mean, if you are a man, you are a provider. It is your responsibility to ensure the safety of your loved ones. So with this program, I think we will be able to achieve that.
So we started, we are in Gauteng. Wanted to take it, especially when it comes to rural areas, I think this could be very important. It's where there's so much abuse there, because there's lack of knowledge. So what is your plan of taking this, especially to rural areas, to educate people about the finances?
Look, with On The Money,
yes,
we are doing On The Money countrywide.
Yes, sir.
We have facilitators across the country who are focusing on doing this for rural development, because as I'm speaking to you now, we have an initiative called FSC,
okay,
Financial Service Sector Charter. We are looking at the rural areas. We are doing these programs there every day, from Monday to Friday, and sometimes even on weekends. We do this for the rural people who are living in the rural areas, because we want to see them changing their lives for the better.
Oi, oi, I've got this Bura Law. I mean, for the fact that you've been part of this Amataima, the impact that Chitimba and you guys came up with this concept, what is that you want to see changing in our community, in our society?
I think number one, I appreciate the opportunity to be a part of this. I'd like to congratulate everybody that is a part of this. For me, I'd say three things.
Yeah.
Number one, I'd say we like looking at a lot of our problems through the lens,
okay,
of a westernized education or westernized upbringing,
yeah,
or a westernized brainwashed mindset that has been experiencing this brainwashing for decades and decades through media, through TV, through newspapers, through propaganda, etc., etc. So the first thing we need to find and discover within ourselves, in the center of ourselves, that nucleus is African spirituality. And what was the teachings, nabasakula bona, and how do you incorporate that with your recent latest westernized education, number one, right? Number two, I would say the family is under attack. I would say unkulunkulu is under attack. And for me, the answer is unkulunkulu. If you can find unkulunkulu, bathi la kuba unkulunkulu, and yonke into oyifunayo la ka unkulunkulu, mele utholena qala. Njengoba ngizokushayela around HRT, mele ngicela ukuyi permission ukuthi ngibambe amakomishi lapha yini. So a lot of us, we turn to neglect unkulunkulu. But even unkulunkulu wethu sometimes is a little bit skewed, because it's through a lens of a westernized education or religious education, or something that I would not want to delve into right now.
Okay.
But I think those are some of the things we need to go fix. If a family unit is under attack, then let's rise as men. Let's take responsibility, accountability. Nobody's going to pay me. Nobody's going to ask me to stand up. Let me stand up, because it's my responsibility to fight for my family, to fight for my community. And then lastly, without having to speak for too long, I'll definitely say wealth creation. Wealth creation, I want to check out my flop up idea, because of Nyungu.
Okay.
The divorce pack in Nyungu. Relationships are the breakup.
It's all about your material stuff, yeah.
I think a lot of the times in Nyungu, you know? And in Nyungu, not in a way or maybe Santubeli or no flesh or whatever, but just for the Nyungu to look after your family. Because even if you look at the animal kingdom, you know, the leader of the family goes to hunt. And as much as things can change, and we can say, oh, I'm going to get 2022, it's change sheets. As much as regarded change sheets, at the end of the day, our women are equal, but at the same time, as men, we have to take responsibility to protect these women, but at the same time, know the importance of that scent that comes and gets put on the on top of the table.
The words that you have learned, you benefited from the Old Mutual today.
All right. Well, my name is David Modise. I'm director and founder of Jod Consultancy, which is a company that deals with outdoor advertising, and we have a broad spectrum. So what I have personally learned is you are not alone. Not a single thing that you're going through is unique to you. So literally, I have sat here and I've met brothers who are going through the same things that I'm going through, brothers who are speaking the same language that I'm speaking, and it's like, geez, okay, so it's not isolated to me.
So with this kind of events, I mean, conferences, I think also it should not just end here, but we'd like to see it more, especially in rural areas, because it's where people from rural also should benefit from this.
100%. I agree, because you must remember here, unfortunately, it's a handful of us. But you need to bridge the gap and reach the guy who stays at Soweto, Tembisa, East London, wherever it is. Because it's literally the most incredible thing is men 6 to 60.
Yeah.
We think the same, we speak the same language. You can literally take a 25-year-old man, put him in a room with a 40-year-old man. The most incredible thing is the conversation will be the same.
Yes.
So 100%, I agree with you there.
So what is that you want to see, like, in terms of achievement, having these conversations every corners of South Africa, what is that you want to see changing?
Mind shift
financial
of men.
Financial or in
mind shift of men, in everything. Okay. Mind shift of men when it comes to their families.
Yeah.
Mind shift of men when it comes to spending money. Because one of the things that I actually said when I was in there is, the most incredible thing is, you work. At the end of the month, you make irresponsible financial decisions just because you're like, it's been such a long month.
Do you know what I mean? Yes. What is your take on the insights that we have today?
They're brilliant. They're brilliant because they're giving men a platform to voice out, to express, to also learn. Because when you're a man, you're expected to know it all and not have enough emotion to cry. So this is an environment where we as men came together and we're vulnerable with each other, so it's important.
I love for the fact that you're in touch, especially with young people.
Yeah.
You see, me and you have got this opportunity to come to Hudson Hotel, but I think we should have this much broader, having more, I mean, young people, especially Ekasi, having this type of conversation. What is your take on having this thing more than having, I mean, limited space like this one?
No, that's a great point. Yes. I mean, we need to go to where the young people are, we need to go to where the problems are.
Yes.
The solutions can be divided and be far apart from the problem and the solution can't live far apart from each other. They must be here for us to move on. So what you're saying is incredible, and it's 100% something that I support. You need to make sure that you find the next conference is in Tembisa, is in Soweto, is in Alexandra, is goes as far as Kukuleto, goes Chieho, and so forth.
So what did you learn from this, especially when it comes to finances, what Old Mutual they put together? Yeah.
No, great lessons from Old Mutual, and shout out to Old Mutual for giving the platform for men to discuss finances. I've learned that we still have a long way to go, and we should double our efforts into taking the institution of knowledge and money and how to use money, how to invest into the households, not only just into the virtual spaces.
Yes.
We need to go inside the households.
This is personal. I mean, you sound so sharp, dedicated, and not of homemakers.
Sure.
I mean, what made you to be who you are?
Yeah.
Because you've got a different character, personality.
It's a way of life. It's the upbringing.
Okay.
So it's something that we need to thank my parents, yes. my family, my friends, the people I came across.
Yes.
Because, and again, just thank the universe and the ancestors, because when I meet you, you influence my life one way or another. So I'm happy that even the people I've met along the way, they've influenced me to become this person, you know? So it's not my doing, it's not by my intelligence, it's not by my design. It's literally thanks to the universe conspiring in my favor.
So are you taking what you have gained to empowering, especially the young ones?
Yeah.
Because remember, you're a public figure and everyone looks at you and say, sure. I mean, I would like to be like him.
Oh yeah, certainly. I mean, there's the same reason why I decided to build my dream house in Soweto, not leave Soweto, because it's important that I give back practically, not just through the TVs and the radio. The kids must wake up and see me and see how I live and see so that they've got role models that are accessible. Because when you do well and leave the township, you are saying that the negative role models must be the ones dominating the township. So that's why, I mean, to answer your question, definitely giving back to the township is a good idea.